I allowed my confidence to take me where my character could not keep me because I was lacking integrity. To be on the ball podcast. But the last thing I want to talk about, like I said before, is integrity. While I was in that same grad school program, I started, everything was great. But then one day my teacher, she came to me. She turned in my essay, said, "Do you mind if I talk to you after class?" I said, "Okay, not a problem. What you wanna talk about?" She said, "Just talk to me over here." Pulled me out the class, took me another empty classroom. I knew that wasn't gonna be good at all. Then she started talking to me, said, "Jonathan, I got a question for you. I just don't understand in regards to this paper." She said, "I mean, I looked at your paper and I graded it, and I looked at this other student's paper, and it looks a little bit similar." She said, "Jonathan, help me understand. Like, what are we even looking at right now? Help me understand." And I was like, "I mean, what you mean? My paper? I did the paper. I turned it in. What you want me to say?" She said, "No, Jonathan, I'm gonna ask you one time." She said, "Did you write this paper, or did you copy off somebody else?" I was like, "No, I wrote that paper." But the night before, I procrastinated. I waited. I took my time because I was good. I got overconfident. Then I just chipped away at the paper, but I was referring to my friend's paper that she was talking about, and I knew the whole time. Then she said, "Okay, Jonathan, well, since you don't want to be honest with me, I'm just going to pass to the department head, and we'll let him make the last decision. We'll let him talk through it. After that, we'll go from there." Then I'm sitting down talking with him. He says, "Jonathan, I mean, the paper looks similar." And he was real cool, dude. He said, what are we even looking at? What are we talking about, Jonathan? Like, if you copy the paper, just tell me you copy the paper. We can move on." I was like, "I didn't copy the paper, but I might have shared the same references. Might have used the same resources. But I wrote the rest of the paper. It was just the resources." Then as I was looking at that, and I began to think about integrity, then I began to realize that's not where that character flaw started. It didn't start in grad school. It started when I was in middle school, when I would go hang out with my homeboy. We'd go to the gas station. We'd hit a quick lick. I'd steal some candy, steal some shoelaces from my Tim's. Then it got to the point where it just began to grow. I began to feed it. It began to grow. It was a lack of integrity. Then I go to Walmart. I was stealing Dickie Fits. It got to the point where it was so bad where as school was getting ready to let out, we like last three weeks of school, everybody started wearing the same clothes. It got to the point where I just started coming with new outfits. All the way to the end of school, I'm wearing brand new stuff. Everybody else repeating the same stuff. I'm like, "What y'all doing? Why y'all got no new clothes?" And it was to the point where I almost felt like buying clothes and buying things was a waste of money because I began to steal that much. Like that. I'm just saying, I can be honest about it because I dealt with it. Everything that I ended up stealing was more than I had to pay back. I don't believe in karma. I believe in what you sow is what you reap. And we talk about integrity. And some of y'all in here, just like me at that time, had a character flaw. I allowed my confidence to take me where my character could not keep me because I was lacking integrity. And I think just when we talk about integrity and with you all being in here and with you all starting your college career, I think this is a great place to start. This is a great place to begin to build. Because if you know that there's some stuff that you're operating with and you can't get it right, now's a great time to start. Because after identifying that, I had to reflect. Because after I got fired from that job, after I had to get a new transmission because I was out there and doing stuff I ain't had no business doing, after I had to go and then apply to another grad school because I got kicked out because I was plagiarizing, even though me and the other girl, we were both sitting in the office, they said, "Well, what are we going to do?" And I said, "I have to take the fall because I'm the one who cheated. It wasn't her, it was me." Because some of us in here, we got to step up and we got to accept that we got a flaw somewhere. And if we know that we have a flaw, we can do two things. We can act ignorant to it and say, "Nah, I'm good. That's not me. He ain't talking to me talking. He's talking to somebody beside me. He's not talking about me. I'm good." But then once we leave, once we go home, and then once some of y'all in the dark of your dorms, in the dark of your apartments, in the dark of your room, wherever it is, everything that's done in that dark place eventually comes out to the light.